This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. I'll make a motion to call the meeting to order. Do I have a second?
That's your second.
All in favor, say, oh, Thea, would you call the vote?
Trustee Keating?
Keating, aye.
Trustee Lampier? Lily, you're muted.
Lily, you're muted.
Up, you are in. Trustee Stetser?
Stetser, aye.
Trustee Lampier?
Lampier, aye.
Gotcha.
Lampier, aye.
Gotcha. Okay, looks like Frank didn't make the meeting, so Mayor Corby?
Corby, aye.
Okay. And Mary just informed me that Frank is not making the meeting tonight, so.
Okay, thank you.
Was not planning to attend, that is correct.
Correct. Okay. All right, so I think the first thing on the agenda, Bob, is the home rule?
Is the home rule. Does everybody have a copy of this resolution with the two bill numbers that, thanks to Renee, we have gotten from our state assembly person and our new state senator?
Yes.
Okay, any discussion?
I did wonder if, since the bill language had changed, if we need to change that intro paragraph to, it says village-wide speed limit, do we need to specify state? I mean, the most important thing is that the bill language itself says state-owned roads. Do we need to?
I think it should be explicit, Renee, I agree.
Okay, so let me pull that up real quick. And we want to change the second whereas paragraph, just add reducing the village-wide speed limit on state-owned roads to 25 miles per hour is more appropriate for a dense walkable. It doesn't read as nice. It's the only problem. Let me see, village-wide speed limit.
No, but it is more explicit, so.
Okay, sounds good.
Let's just get it done. Yeah.
Okay, well, if there's no further discussion, I'll make the edits when I, and I'll make the motion, but I just want to make sure there isn't any other discussion.
Any other comments? Okay. Renee, do you want to make the motion?
Yes, I will make a motion to, I don't see a name on this resolution.
It's the Homer resolution for the 25 mile.
That's all I have to call it. There's no title up top. So I will make a motion to adopt the home rule legislation for the 25 mile per hour speed limit legislation that is in both the assembly and Senate in New York. And with the addition of change to the second paragraph, whereas reducing the village-wide speed limit on state-owned roads to 25 miles per hour is more appropriate. So we're just inserting state-owned roads.
I'll second the motion.
Okay. Roll call. Okay, Trustee Keating?
Keating, aye.
Trustee Lampier?
Lampier, aye.
Trustee Stetser?
Stetser, aye.
Mayor Corby?
Corby, aye.
Motion passes.
Okay, now we're gonna turn it over to Mary.
I think, Lily, maybe you want to do your motion?
Sure. I would like to request that the board approve the only bid that we received from Bunshu for the flowers, for the planting in the spring. And that bid is for $4,600, which is $235.42 less than it was last year. The prices of the baskets, window boxes, and pots remain the same. The reason for the change, the difference in the price, is because this year we do not need any replacement baskets. The additional price last year was because we needed more baskets. So I am asking the board to please approve the bid for $4,600 for next year's spring planting.
And I would just like to make the comment that bids were sent out to multiple vendors. We only had one response. So it is, the process has been done in fulfillment of our procurement policy.
Correct. It's interesting to note that the all three, with the exception of benches, I used to send out four bids, of the three, they've all retired. No one is doing this any longer. So it's become quite challenging. But luckily, Bun Shoes does an excellent job, and they haven't raised prices on us in the last 3 years.
Okay. Did you second it, Dan?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Dorothea, would you do a roll call vote, please?
Sure. Trustee Keating?
Keating, aye.
Trustee Lamphere?
Lamphere, aye.
Trustee Stetzer?
Stetzer, aye.
Mayor Corby?
Corby, aye.
Motion passes.
Thank you.
Okay.
Before we get going with Mary, I do just want to put it on the record. I still am concerned that we have at least three people in the building at Village Hall right now, which isn't safe given the pandemic. So I'm hoping that we can utilize our technology that we all have to improve on that and better isolate. Thank you.
I guess I would respond to that by saying we have completed a draft pandemic plan. We are abiding by all recommendations for social distancing and safe protocol within the building. For my own presence, I am classified as an essential worker. I had been in the building most of the day, and there's no additional risk for me to be here during the meeting. It also is helpful because I didn't have all the documents I needed for this meeting. There were issues with my laptop, which Dorothea was able to solve. Everybody is in socially distanced at our stations currently. There is no risk to anyone. Okay.
I hear you, and I don't think you can say there's no risk to anyone. I disagree with that. So
yeah, we'll agree okay. to disagree. Yeah, thanks, so, Dan. It's not on the agenda tonight, so we're going to move on with the budget meeting, which is on our agenda.
Neither were the flowers. Thank you.
Oh, sorry. That was my fault because I was supposed to put it on last week, and it's time sensitive because they have to get the order in or we won't get our flowers planted. So
yes, agreed.
No, I did request ahead of time.
I have no problem with it whatsoever. I'm just, if Bob's going to point that out about an agenda item that I add that is an emergency, I'll point out that I'm not the only one. Thanks.
Okay. All right. All right. Mary, would you like to start on what we're going to go through tonight on the budget?
Yes. You have your digital packet. So what I've put in there was the wish list item. I had pulled out what you need, what you said to go forward with, and I've incorporated that in the numbers. So I'm just going to go through quickly what I do have and what I don't have, and then we'll go to the numbers.
Mary, before
your
you
first
get
couple
going,
of pages.
Mary, before you get going, can I request? We've talked about this before. Can I request that we look into again with our vendor on how to get reports in Excel? It really could do a lot more with these reports if they were in Excel. So coming right out of the accounting system, that would be really helpful. It has to be possible. If you'd like my help with it, I'm happy to help with it. But that there might be an upgrade needed. There might be an additional cost. I don't know, but
I can contact them. It's fine.
That would be great. Just find out what it entails, and if you want my hand with it, that'd be great. But we really could do a lot with these. And I know, Justin Lightgeb is also very handy in Excel, so we'll be able to do some really good work on it. Thanks.
Okay. Moving forward, I've had your wish list that I updated, so we'll go back to that because we'll have to refer to that. I also, Dorothy also reached out to the attorney. So in your package, you have our verbal quotes from Osborne and Reed and a quote from Hudson Ross, which I also incorporated. You've got the little account numbers alongside, so that's where you'll see that in the packet. The next one in there is from Heister Building Restoration, which is a big number for the Village Hall. And as we're going through having to chisel back numbers or make a decision on what numbers should be used or not, here's a breakdown of the 27.5. The next one, non-negotiable item, FOPV agreement for June 1 payment of $33,167. I've incorporated that. Hudson Ross, a June 1 payment of $46,000. I've put in that one. Also with this one, depending on where we fall out with in May with the numbers, then we can maybe send over a few extra dollars to bring down this cost and reduce our agreement time. But
Mary, question
to be determined, not until May.
Mary, question for you. So I have questions along the way. Do you want to get all the way through and then take questions, or do you want to take questions when you're talking about the specific item?
You can ask me as we go along.
As we go. Okay, then go back up to I have two questions so far. The first is on it's on the page, it's on the sixth page of the packet, which has the quote from Dan Spitzer. And it looks like it's an ORB thing, and it's on like a piece
of
paper.
Are you referring to this?
Hold on, let me see.
That's what you're referring to?
Yeah, the yellow part. Can we get a more formal
the yellow part?
Can we get a more formal quote from them than that?
I'm not hearing you.
Mary, you're cutting in and out, but I can answer that question. Jeff was trying to email me the numbers and had a problem. So what he did is called me and gave me the number, so we have it for budget time. He will get a formal email over.
Okay, great. Because that's
I can't hear you.
That's a little back in the napkin.
No, that was just my quick scribble, so Mary had the numbers.
Sure. Yeah, no problem. The next question. So, Mary, are you hearing us now?
I don't think she is. Hold on.
You keep freezing on my screen.
Hold on.
I am not hearing you. Your screen keeps freezing on me. What about me? All right, let me hold on so we can straighten out technical difficulties.
Dan, what page are you going to next so we can all be there?
The next one is right where she was, which is page 8. I'm sorry, not page 8, page 9. That's the one on Hudson Russ.
The one after the yellow sticky?
No, it's page 9. It's after the FOPV one. It's after the NOF shop.
I don't see page numbers yet. So
okay. It's Hudson Russ agreement is at the top. Amendment to letter of engagement dated 5/27/14. Okay. Yep. I can also just share my screen. It's this one. See it there?
You're not sharing yet, but yeah, there we go. Yeah, that's where I was. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I can see movement on everybody this time around, which I didn't, my camera's off. I wonder if it's got anything to do with my camera.
Might leave your
I'm on, we'll see if it freezes again. I don't know what the problem is.
Okay, so then the next question.
Okay. Wait. To go back to where we were, this is the page we're looking for, which was about the third one in. And on it is an email from Hodson Ross and a tacky note that I had tacked to the top of the page, which is from Osborne, Reed, and Burke for their quotes that they provided for me this week. So that's just a quick kind of thing for right now as a placeholder. I'm sure we'll have a formal one that will come through. This is just what I have for right now.
Okay, thanks.
Is everybody good with this?
Yes.
Dan, is that answering your questions?
Yeah, we talked about it while you were off. So all good. So really just looking for a formal quote there. So the next question is on page 9, which is the
Hodson. I'm freezing.
Maybe just dial in on a phone.
Mary, why don't you turn off your camera? Try that.
Turn off the camera. Yeah, turn off the camera.
No, I'm gonna turn off the camera and see if that works. I have no idea why we're having issues here. Okay, can everybody hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Is everybody hearing me? Yes.
Yes.
It's my night for technical difficulties. I'm sorry. Okay. What was the next question, Dan?
Mary, are you hearing me?
Yes, I am.
Okay. So on Hodson Russ, on the Hodson Russ agreement, it's page 9 in the packet. It says Hodson Russ agreement amendment to letter of engagement dated 5/27/14. Can you help us to?
First of all, Dan, I don't have numbers on my page. So you got to hold on. Let me get to that page. You're talking about Hodson. You don't need to share the screen. I got it. I just need to see where you're talking about. Hodson Ross agreement. Okay.
Yeah. What I want to understand better is we have prior payments from before 2020, and then we have 2020 payments, and then we have 2021 budgeting. So really, we have three separate categories of Hodson Russ payments. Can you help us to understand what those numbers are for 2019, 2020, and then projections for 2021, please?
At the end of 2019-20, we had a total outstanding for Hodson Russ of $169,181.52. At which point, at that time, we had gone into an agreement to pay some of the money back to them. And what we did was pay some really old bills for a total of $32,000, which left us with a balance of $137,181.52. The balance divided over by three is $45,727.17. So the agreement on the flip side says that we will pay equal amounts over the next 3 years to pay off this debt. It is an agreement that we're in for 3 years. So at this point, I am anticipating
pause there for a minute. So that 45 a year covers 19-20 or 19. So fiscal year 19, fiscal year 20.
Yes, it covers all those invoices above. Okay. Those are the listed invoices that are above that we did not pay. We paid a portion of the $32,000. So the balance of the $137,000, we are dividing that balance over 3 years to pay off that amount. Additionally, are you good?
Yeah, no, so it does not cover June of 20 through the end of May 21.
Correct.
And then
because those we are paying as we go along. So okay. When we receive a Hodson Ross bill that I send to the board at this time, this fiscal year, that invoice is scheduled up for payment. In addition to those current invoices that we'll be receiving throughout this year, we are also in an agreement separate from those invoices for three more years for a total of $46,000 each year.
Okay, so that $46,000 won't go up with the amount from June of 20 through May of 21. We're going to pay those bills as they come in. So that $45,727 that we pay won't change over the next 3 years.
That is correct, because we're working away at a balance that they have agreed to pay for us to pay without interest or anything. So they're getting their money. We're getting it back. Additionally, though, if there is money left over in the budget from their lines that we have not spent, the board agreement from last year's budget was that we would apply additional monies to these, to this agreement, to help us reduce the amount of money that we have on these divided payments. I don't know what that you're trying to show me there. I can't read that.
Okay, thank you. All right.
Is that good?
Yes. So when we get to the budget line items, what we're essentially going to have current amounts. We're going to have projections for February through May of 21. And then we're going to have projections for fiscal year 21-22.
We are not discussing February through May of 21 at this time. We are going forward and looking at what we are looking to spend, or, well, spend basically for an expense with Hodgson Ross from June 1, 2021 through May 31st, 2022. This is an additional agreement that is reflected in our budget for this year and throughout. Just to come back into the current budget year, if Dan Spitzer sends us an invoice for $4,000 tomorrow, that would go up against our bills to be cleared and paid this year, not into the next year. That's okay. Part of the pay-as-you-go arrangement.
Okay.
Is that clear? Or do you need further?
No, it's good.
Clarification?
Thank you, I understand it.
Okay. All right, so that basically is a non-negotiable item. The next non-negotiable item in the packet is the Ravo sweeper. And this year, we are needing to pay out on June 21st, $23,747.42. Non-negotiable. That's part of the lease. The other one is for the 2019 Ford 450. That is a payment due out for $11,926.74, non-negotiable. All right, those I've already added to the budget as we see it. So that's just a general overview of what's in the packet. And I'd like to now go into what the budget runs are for the numbers as we came through. So my first go-to place right now is the sewer fund, because it's quick and easy and there wasn't a lot of additions in there. When I ran the numbers, which included all the CIPP work for Sutherland and let me see, I've got lost it. South Street, I think it was. Hang on one second. It was for CIPP sanitary sewer lining for 85 South Street and east and west side of Sutherland Street. So that was a total of $139,000. So I included that in the run. When I did that and put in our tentative numbers from what I knew at this time, we come up with, without going into a lot of discussion around it, a use of a appropriated fund balance of $90,293. So the bottom line to this, which does not need to be for discussion tonight, is if the board is wanting to have all this work done next year or not, and how much of it, which would change the $90,293 number. So when I'm talking about the appropriated fund balance for the sewer fund, I've also included for you in the second page of that, the sewer fund analysis of unreserved fund equity. The number at the end of 12/31/20 was 576,458.11. The estimated number for the end of the year for 5/31/20 21 is $670,843.72. So aside from maybe some minor adjustments that will take place at year end, there is plenty of money in this fund. If the board had decided to go ahead and do all of these CIPP projects without really hindering us too much off the $670,000 balance. Okay.
I think we should probably hold that discussion until Frank is able to attend the meeting.
Right. I just wanted to let the board know where I stood with it as far as numbers were concerned. It's just informational for the board tonight. Okay.
Great. I think it helps to have it in there, and then if we and know about it, and it's one of the levers we can pull if we need to.
Okay, so that said, I'm moving on to the general fund, which is the biggest problem as always. So we look at the general fund.
Mary, excuse me, what page are you on?
It's general fund trial balance.
It's on the screen.
Can you see it, Bob?
Page 19.
Oh, you can't see me.
On this laptop, the screen is too small. I can't read it. So I'm that's why I'm have to leave.
It's page 19.
All right, well,
this one right here. I see it. I've got it. Thank you.
Yeah, hey, Mary, it's the one that says.
Before you get going, before you get into the general fund, so really wanted to talk to the other two trustees about this. I could not make the kickoff meeting to this last week or 2 weeks ago. So this is the first I've had a chance to talk to you all about the budget. In general, my approach at this point is, given the pandemic and the financial situation we're in, I am strongly in favor of not raising taxes. We raised it last year during the beginning of the pandemic, and I can't see. I'm hoping that we can do the work and make the hard choices so that we don't have to raise taxes this year. I don't know where you guys are, but that's where I'm coming at it from.
Okay, Dan, as regarding the revenues at this time, I've made no modifications to the revenues. I'm holding off to see what our revenue stream does come in and look like over the next month. That'll give us a better handle on what things are, and I'm also waiting to see what the Office of the Comptroller suggests for any kind of changes or modifications that I need to be concerned with. So right now, I'm not even concerned about where the revenues are. For the purposes of today, I left all revenues flat. So if that helps you out any, it does drive the number, but it is what it is for today. This is just a kind of a placeholder to see where the wish list kind of fell out. So that said, when I ran the numbers, my appropriations were $1,763,708,000. My property taxes, which are flat from this year, is $879,478, and other revenues were $591,039. That suggests that if all things were included in the budget as had been dictated from last week, we would have to be using an appropriated fund balance of $293,191. We don't have an appropriated fund balance that we can tap into for this. This figure, at the end of the day, when we're done with this budget, revenues need to equal appropriations. So the figure where it says appropriated fund balance needs to say zero. So that is just FYI for the board. That's what I'm driving to reduce or close the gap at. Okay?
Yep.
Moving on. Going to general fund, page one, appropriations. What I did in these numbers, and some of this still I still have to sift out because we've had, Brooklyn and I have had kind of an intense run of training and trying to get our sewer rents out, and I'm glad he's coming back every single day. I've been putting him through the ringer. So anyway, everything isn't up to snuff that I would like. There will be some modifications just from my end, but going through, generally speaking, all wages are up at 2.5% from this current year. That includes the board. I kept basically the conferences is the same as I did last year for things, so that doesn't change it. My 1410 account is going to change.
Can you pause there for a minute, Mary? Can you kind of take a note that the conferences might be a place to cut given the pandemic, that conferences aren't happening anyway? Just circle it, maybe one place that we might possibly cut.
I understand that. I'm putting in some money into their dam because even though the physical being of being at the conference is not there, NICOM has switched a lot of the conferences to online, and with some of those conferences, there is a cost associated with it. So considering we will have new board members coming in, there may be a good reason for them to attend these conferences. And so that's why I was leaving as a placeholder. Yes, it might be able to be reduced in the end, but that was my reasoning behind it.
I understand.
And also we have two new staff members that need to go through training. So that's kind of a must there. All right. Let me see. We're still waiting for some quotes and answers for things like the insurance expenses, you know, any of the insurances, whatever they may be, from different vendors to give us an idea about how much that increase will be, because it could be 5% or it could be 12. We don't know that. If they can give us a feel for it, that would be helpful. So I'm going by just what I've been increasing things with in the past. I'm not certain these numbers are perfect at this time, but I'm using them as a placeholder. All right.
Hey, Mary, along those lines, the next time you do this, could you do us a favor and kind of maybe circle or put an asterisk or something by the ones that you don't have final numbers on, that you don't have quotes on, because that'll help us to understand a little better as to what might still move a little up or down.
At this time, Dan, I could safely say that none of my numbers are final numbers. This is the first time I put everything together, and kind of hoping that what I have here is kind of fairly close, but I won't have any final numbers for a little while, but I'm trying to work with what I got just to have an idea of where we are falling out. I'm trying not to go off the deep end on things, but try and incorporate things as we go along.
Okay.
I would also add that, you know, Mary has been working diligently with Dorothea and Zach and some of our vendors to get accurate numbers. So there's a lot of work involved to coordinate that. It is underway. And I just want to give Mary a pat on the back for all the work that she's done in a pretty short period.
Thank you. Yes. Yes, we do have several phone calls out to the vendors. We're just sitting and waiting on having them get our information together, but I don't have the answers right now.
All right, great.
I'm trying to move this along.
Great. And when you do get them, just put a little check mark by it or something. Like that's a good solid number.
I will inform the board. All right. Moving on from here, let me see. We're on page 2 of the general fund under law. The references that I made to you earlier regarding Osborne and Hodson Ross are the numbers that I've incorporated within this document. I am still waiting for some sort of number to come back from Mindy. I don't have that. So this is where it's falling out at the moment. And that is dependent on their services. And I can't call it unless they let me know what that is. Are we good to move on to page 3?
So just at a high level, yep, we budgeted for 265 for 1920. We budgeted for 237. And so we're going down a little in our projections so far.
We are going down in our projections so far based on the estimates that the attorneys have provided for us. It's not a number I pick out of the sky.
I know.
It's a number that they provide to us. I just wanted you to be clear.
I'm clear.
Okay.
So, but we don't have final numbers from everybody. So that this could
we
go
do,
up.
We do not.
Yeah.
This whole process for us isn't going to be sewn up until we have a tentative budget in place at the end of March. Yeah. So any of our numbers can shift between now and then, depending on how things fall out within the categories. And Mary, as information comes into us.
Can you go to, so the total expenditures through 12/31/2020 is 61,446.07, which seems low on a budget of 237. So either
it might be, but we have, you know, those attorney bills, Dan, that I send out to the board and to you for approval. Unless they're paid, they don't get posted. They don't get posted. They don't roll into the numbers. That's why it's important for us to review them and send them up for payment, because then I post them within the month and we have a more accurate picture about what our actual is to the estimate that the attorney provided for us. So this is all that we paid this year. We still have a bunch of invoices. I know there's like about 25,000 that's outstanding at the moment that I'm aware of. So that would have, if these were all paid, that would have driven that number.
Yeah, but even with the 25 paid, we're still less than 100 on a 237 budget.
That's awesome, really, because that means we're coming in under budget. That's better for us in the long run. We're not spending out as much as what we had planned on. In a perfect world, if everything fell under budget, we could end up having a surplus, which is what our goal is at the end of the year. We're hoping to just break even at this point. And considering that we are in a pandemic and all numbers are flying around everywhere, it's hard to predict anything. So the litigation costs from all the attorneys are dependent on what is happening and what they're charging us for. So I mean, that there's nothing we can do to control that.
Okay, so can I ask the question now? So the question I was going to ask was, do we anticipate a heavier than normal, like are the invoices that we expected to come in, have they come in? Do we put a check mark next to Hodson Russ, Zoglin, Osborne for each of the months, or there's still some gaps to come?
As I receive them, I turn them over to everybody. So yes, there are some that are outstanding. Are they outstanding as far as they haven't billed us? I can't answer you that question, because what I just forward to you what I receive.
Okay.
So as far as I'm concerned, we're current with what they're giving us, other than what we have not paid at the moment.
Okay, that might be something interesting for us to do, Mary. Maybe that a me and you task, to try and understand whether there are outstanding invoices that we haven't received yet. Believe me, I'd be thrilled with the surplus too. I just don't want to get smacked with a cash flow issue, because there's a huge gap between 61 and 237.
I agree. But if you even take kind of what I have that I'm thinking about, a 25,000, we're like at 86,000 against the budget of 237. We're like halfway home almost for the year. And if we come in under that number, that would be awesome. I mean, that would be nice to know that we did not spend what we had initially, you know, sent out there.
And the other thing I would say about that is that the biggest anticipated expense was the appeal, which is done, provided that the settlement that we're currently in continues to go forward.
Okay, are we good to move forward?
Yep,
I think so.
Okay. All right, under page 3 of the appropriations under engineer, I had included under category A 1440.42 South Street design work. In talking with Bob and going over the paperwork that I had from Frank's notes, design work would be a minimum of about $25,000 on the South Street project, which seems to be the only conceivable thing that we would probably be able to get finished towards that project for this coming fiscal year. The rest of the total project is $250,000 approximately, not including whatever the latest inflation costs would be to what was initially proposed to us. So the $25,000 is what I'm plugging on this grid here. Questions?
I have a question on.
You have a question on what? I don't hear you.
You're muted, Renee.
The line on South Street design work. I thought some of the design work was done previously. Was that just preliminary?
That was just preliminary. This would be construction documents.
Okay.
And it would include at least one permanent speed pillow in the long straightaway stretch there. So we would incorporate handicapped accessibility improvements, repairs to the stormwater drainage system, and what am I forgetting? Some curb ramps where they're required.
What's the timing on how that would work with the bridge work? Like, let's say we had the money to do this. How would that work? When is the bridge done?
The bridge is going to be done mid-July of this year.
Mid-July of 21. Okay, so this would, in theory, the South Street work would happen after that?
Correct.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, to move on?
Yes.
Yep.
Records management, I have 1,500 in conferences, but it's not just conferences. I should change that title to reflect and any kind of digital services that we may need for archiving if we send any of our files out. It would include those costs. I need to talk with Sophie to see what she has planned for the upcoming year. I have not had an opportunity to do that. So again, I'm just using 1500 as a placeholder, and we'll see how to modify that number after I talk with her. Under buildings, 1620.4 Village Hall improvements, I have 48,000. 48,000, if you go back to the wish list items, that would include the notice display boards for 1200, building repairs from Heister that he mentioned, and I had mentioned in the beginning of the meeting that there are several categories that maybe should be looked at to decide if what might be critical to get done for this year and what maybe can be pushed out to next. So a total of 27.5 at the moment. Heater replacement is 15,000. We are still waiting for a quote from George. The Ring camera was brought up last time around, and that was for $250. It's a minor thing, and that's included in this $48,000 number. I think the number comes up to like $43,000 for all of it, and I threw an extra for anything that might be an emergency that does happen that we do have to address and hopefully have the money for. So that takes care of that one.
Do you have in the wish list, Mary? I had gotten a quote for restaining the two pavilions on Shane Place. Is that included in here? I don't see it.
Nope, I don't have that quote. If you can forward it to me, I'll incorporate it and we'll see where we fall out. Do you remember what the number was, Bob? Just curious.
I think it was like $1,700 or something. And Dorothea has the quote. I got it from Rick Chanette, the person who painted Village Hall the last time. If we don't have it, I'll call him and I'll get it again.
All right. I'll add it to the list and incorporate the number.
Thank you.
Let me just throw that in it. Pavilion stain. $1,700. All right, 1620.42, I have a figure in there of a total of 13,000, and that category takes care of office cleaning and village hall mats. So because of the pandemic and with the possibility of the village hall opening to the public, we need increased cleaning here at the office. So we've got a quote for $6,240, which is $520 a month for cleaning services, though. I incorporated that along with the village hall mats. All right. 1620.43 DPW desk and washer dryer combo. That number is incorporated in the 1620.43 number at the bottom of the page that I put in $5,000 for, which gives us a couple of thousand. Again, if something happens, at least maybe we have a little bit of money going forward to remedy that. Next page, four of the appropriations special items. Under special items 1930, 1930.41 are the two settlement agreements that we have that I mentioned to you earlier that we went into in great detail a few minutes ago. So those are the two numbers, 33,170 and 46,000 is rounded figures. Also, please note that 1990.4, the contingency account, excuse me, at this time does not have any money put into it, and we really need to put in that money. I don't know right now what would be an appropriate number, but probably somewhere around 30,000 to be on the safe side.
We have a plug in there of something. So 2030, whatever you think.
I'll put in 30,000. Go ahead, Bob.
No, I was going to say, let's put in 30,000 and then we can dial it back if we need to later on. But I think that's minimally is an appropriate number.
Right. Okay. I put in at the very bottom of the page on safety inspection 3620.41 for Thailand. I did put in $2,000. I kept it as same budget as we've had this year. And in case.
Okay.
Right. That's in case Steve can't provide services for whatever the issue is. We would have to farm it out to Ty Lynn. And I'm sure that's probably a low number, but it is a placeholder for right now.
Yeah.
Page five.
And I would say we may want to talk more about that later on, because we, in our new code, if 75 Monroe goes forward, and we have to hire a consultant to do construction observation and code enforcement, we can charge that back to the project applicant, as most municipalities do that.
Yeah. Mary, you just said that 2,000 might be underestimated. Can you go a little deeper on that?
Because I do not know what the hourly rate might be for whomever it is that may come out. I'm not sure if I got 5 hours in here, 10 hours in here, or whatever. It would be job driven. So I just put in a plug for $2,000. I don't know if that's the right number or not. It would depend on the project. Like Bob said, if the inspector had to go over to, let's say, 75 Monroe to do some special inspection there, and it was 20 hours, it might be a whole different thing. I don't know what an hourly rate is. It might be dependent on the inspector that they send out.
We can probably talk to Steve, Mary, and I think we can probably reduce that number. But before we plug something in, let's talk to Steve and we'll get a informed estimate of what it should be.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay.
I agree, Bob, mostly because if you look, our year to date is zero. So,
Bob, if you like, I can reach out to Ty Lynn. I think that contract's due for an update anyway, and get numbers.
Yep. I think we need to do
it's
that.
It's probably a great idea.
Yep.
All right. Yeah, in years past when Steve wasn't here and I was here by myself with no building inspector, I was reaching out to Ty Lynn to do, village inspections, permits and whatever. So that you know, that does mean a lot there. All right, are we good to move forward?
Yes.
Yeah.
On page 5, under street engineering, category A5020.4, road work, I have 65,600 in there. And what that encompasses is crack sealing all the roads, lawn restoration at 21 Monroe, speed humps replacement at Boughton Avenue, hot patch, and maybe I just did this twice. I think I can just reduce this number twice. I have under 5020 South Street reconstruction, I put in 25,000, but I think I included that 25,000 under engineering. Let me just double check. I did, so I can back off $25,000 off the figure that I have on road work up here.
Great.
So that would be 40,600 right now.
A question on 1231 expenditures. So we're at 36,464.01 through the end of December. Do we anticipate this growing before the end of the fiscal year in June? So are we going to exceed our budget number last year?
No. What this road work number reflects is that the 36,464.01 is what we spent on the Village Grove project, which also, by the way, has been fully covered by CHIPS monies. But for comptroller reasons, I have to show the expenditure on the expense side and the CHIPS revenue on the revenue side. So basically, Village Grove was a freebie. Pardon me?
So we don't expect this to grow, the 36,464.01, before the end of the fiscal year?
No. Okay. I mean, if anything, it might be minor if Zach does any kind of patching or something like that, but it'll be minor monies. Okay. There was a huge road project that we did. Okay. Yep. All right. Street maintenance. Under A5110.2 equipment, we have 9,500, which is the utility trailer that we are looking to replace, our 1963-1-4. I think it served us well.
Yep.
So that's incorporated here. Repairs and materials are a little higher than normal because...
Before that, Mary, so right now we've got zero fiscal year to date on a $58,000 budget. Do we expect...
That is correct, because I don't have January posted where we had paid for the T450.
Okay.
The T450 was paid out. It was like $35,000, and additionally, there was some other stuff that went out against it. So that money has not been posted. You will see that figure change when the revenue expenditures say 131.
Okay, so we're not going to find $58,000. Okay.
No.
Thanks.
But nice try.
Yeah, it was a nice try. Can't blame a guy.
Okay. Under repairs and materials, I've got 58.5 against a budget that was 32,000. I reduced it to 30 this year. But what changed, that is just regular, normal, everyday maintenance that we have on our equipment that breaks down and has to go to the shop and whatever. So I use that number as a basis and added to it the extra numbers. I mean, I added to it the toolboxes, the Case 321F tires, the equipment rentals, and the speed sentry signs. So that is the difference, the $28,000 difference there is for those items.
If you go to page one
of the wish list, under category 5110.4, that's the additional number that I put in here for those items in specific, because those are like above and beyond what we would normally have happening in those categories.
Okay.
Are you good, Dan, to move forward? Okay. I think the rest on that page are okay. I did this. Snow removal.
Hold on a minute. Why 5132.1 and 5132.11? Why are those budgeted at zero? Why are there no placeholders there?
Because anything in a 0.1 category, hold on, let me make sure I
put it all up. Yeah.
I put it all into, so they're all sitting in 5110.1 right now until we determine what the wages are.
Yep. And then you disperse it at the very end. Got it.
Right.
Okay. Thanks. Forgot about that.
All right. Moving on to page 6, snow removal. A5142.4, I left the snow contract same from last year, not knowing what kind of winter we're going to have. And obviously this winter, we may not have much snow, but I'm using, you know, the year before we had 7,600. So I'm just 9,000 is a placeholder until we figure it out. We could have a terrible winter and it could be 12,000. We don't know.
Yep.
All right. Moving on.
That separate.
What's that?
Is that the
cost?
That again? Do we share that with the town? I can't remember. Or is that?
They send us a bill.
We receive
our buy it in bulk, and then we go over and we purchase it from the town, and we're billed depending on how much tonnage we use.
Okay.
Right. So it depends on the winter what that cost end up being. All right, under street lighting, A5182.42. I have $16,000. About $6,000 of that is our normal fix and repair for lighting around town. But additionally, I have in there parking lot lighting, which is here at the Village Hall, for $6,500. And I have tree pit lighting. We're still waiting for a quote from Mr. Quagliata, and that's about $5,000.
We were talking. LED conversion. RG&E wants to begin converting our metal halide RG&E lights to LED, but there would be a charge for that, so we need to follow up on that. And I have a contact. I can do that.
Okay.
But it'll be more efficient in the long run, but there is a charge.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Additionally, I have another $2,500 for two new lights above deck on the bridge project. Is that correct?
Yes.
Or did that change?
I think it was just one light. It was actually one light.
One light for
$2,500? It's actually one light which will be located below the bridge, which will hopefully provide light underneath the bridge, which currently is a dark area.
Okay, so the $2,500, Bob, is if an estimate for two lights or one?
One.
Do you recall? One. Okay, so I'll just change this part here. All right, moving on.
That'll go down by $2,500 or up by $2,500?
No, $2,500 is about the cost for one light.
And that's already included in my number here.
That's in the
all 16. Right, moving. That's in the 16,000.
Okay, so it's not going to change.
It's not going to change. Okay. Sidewalks and curbs, 5410.4 replacement. I have $30,000 in there, and that is for the concrete sidewalk driveway apron between 2125 North Main and the State Street sidewalk on the north side of Shown Place to the Village Line. So that takes care of, one is $3,500, another one is $2,500. I put 30 as a rounded number for that.
And we don't think that little section that we talked about last time can be done this year, the section at Northfield Common?
I don't know. Include that also, Renee. I don't think in terms of, we're doing a fairly significant stretch on State Street. I think we could probably add that.
I don't even know.
So, Bob, if...
Oh, go ahead.
No, I was just going to say, If we're adding that section, Bob, what do you feel would be a reasonable number to throw in there additionally to the 30,000?
I would say
another five.
No, four? I would say maybe 2,000 would cover it.
All right, so I'll because change
the setup,
that.
The setup costs will be efficient because we're doing a long stretch, and this really isn't a lot of linear feet.
All right, so why don't I change that number to 32,000 for now, and if we may figure out something different in the long run.
That should be adequate.
Okay. Moving on, under Park 7110.4, I've included 4,500 for the message board, the new decking at the pavilion for 7,000, which also may be a possible grant, but we don't know that at this time. The streetscape flowers and the benches for the State Street corridor, and that I've got at 16.5. Well, there might be a little wiggle room in there that I may have to up it, but that's kind of where I'm at for right now.
Okay.
Moving on, page 7. Under celebration 7550.4, I left 3,000, which was the original budget that we had last year for any events this year. I don't know if we will use any of it due to the pandemic, but based on the other costs that we have in there, that it looks like maybe. So that's just a placeholder. We can talk about that when more is we move along throughout these meetings.
I would just offer that I think it makes sense to leave it in there because of the uncertainty. We don't know when all this is going to end. And if it's in that category, it's always available for contingency where we know we might need it.
I'm kind of curious where the 257322 is.
I'll run a copy of the account and see, but I think we purchased something other, I don't know, Lily, do you remember? I think we purchased something in place of the events money because we were canceling
for candlelight night at the request of the Chamber of Commerce to do a little more decorations. So our expenses for Christmas decorations were a little higher than expected. It may have been that.
All right.
It may have been that. And I think there was some more lighting and stuff that we were we did. I'll have to pull the account and let you know for sure what it.
Oh, Mary, would that
absolutely
be the last I purchased?
I bet you that's
all new lighting for the wreaths and everything this year. $1,700
or something. Yep, that's what I recall.
Yes.
Okay.
All right. See, that's it always correct. Goes to good use. moving along here. Let's see. Bob, I've got under planning here, maybe this is another duplicate, 8020.41. I have $5,000 in there for a bridge project. I think that might have been the design, again, the engineering cost.
I think that might have been, might also be for the Shane Place light. We've got to design it, we've got to install conduit, we've got to connect it to the existing system and buy a decorative light pole. That might be a better, and I forgot, we're going to need about $5,000 to put a light underneath the bridge. I think that's, what do you think, Zach? How much do you think that's going to cost?
$7,500 or so. Labor's not cheap.
Yeah. So that with the other number that you have in the other location will cover it.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
But you're saying about 7,500. I just looked back and I had only $1,000 for engineering for bridge work in this year's budget. I had nothing in next year's for this year for bridge work under engineering. So I would have to raise this category by 2,500. And the other question I have, that work that you just described, because I have a $5,000 placeholder in this year's budget, is that a possibility that it might not get done before May 31st?
It's very, very much a possibility. I think it won't, and probably we don't want to do it. There's not much we can do while the bridge is under construction. So, you know, perhaps we, at the end of the day, we're going to end up paying for design work and the actual light will be installed the next year.
Okay. I'll leave this for right now because it's covering our butts in both years.
Right.
Under consultants, I just carried over the 3,000 that we had.
Or do we want to bump it to 7,500?
That's what I said. I'll bump it up to 7,500 and leave it as a placeholder for now. Because if it materializes in this year by May 31st, 5,000 may cover it. It might not. It might, you know, roll over some of the expense into the new year. So we'll be covered at either end for right now until we have a better picture of what's actually happening. Under 8020.42 consultants, I just kept 3,000 just as a possible if anything happens and we need a consultant for. There are no plans that I am aware of that you would need that, but on the just in case as the year rolls out, you've got something.
What's the difference between a consultant on the in planning? So this would be like you know, Molly and John kind of consultant? Okay. All right. Thanks.
Yes. GIS I put in at 3,400. I have to look at the schedule still and tighten up on that number. I am not sure it's about that, but I'm not sure if it's gone up or down from the 3,338. We'll get billed that towards the end of the year.
Is SRF under a different line for consultants, or is that would that include anything that need SRF to do?
SRF would fall under that same line. So if you have a project that you know is
looking
to transpire for next year, that's where I would throw in that quote. All right. Let me see here. Drainage 8540.4 contractual. I have 50,000 in there, which is a much higher number than I would normally put. Typically, I have between $8,000 and $10,000 there. But the drainage is for repairing or replacing catch basins, and then also we have
North Main Street.
Work
we have to finish the project on North Main Street from Village Hall to the Four Corners, and we have additional work on Locust Street in the westernmost block that includes laterals. So all those catch basins and the pipe underneath the road, which is corrugated metal, is crumbling. That all needs to be replaced. We did the other end of the street this year, and we have to do these two projects this coming year.
All right, so the 50,000 might even be a number that's a little bit too low, but at the moment it's just a placeholder.
I think it's pretty close though. It's pretty close.
Okay. Bob, for replacement trees, I put in the same number that we have had this year. We're spending 1,500. Last year we spent 2,000. We've got 4,000 on budget. We still have more trees to purchase in the spring, so that number should come up pretty close to 4,000. I'm just leaving 4,000 in.
I think that's about what we're gonna need. We took out a bunch of trees this year. There's a bunch of holes, so I think this will keep us on track to keep filling the holes with new trees.
Why? Question here. So why, if the last 2 years were less than 2,000, why do we have to double it to 4?
Well, because we underfunded it for 2 years, and we're beginning to have holes in our urban tree canopy, and a number of trees came out. So we're trying to get back to a sustainable level, so we plant as many trees as we remove.
Right. And the other thing, too, Dan, is we have 1,500, which only reflects the trees that were planted in the fall. We still have a spring planting to do. So that would probably take care of a good deal of that balance. So we're kind of behind the eight ball with some things, but that's the explanation for it.
Thanks.
8560.42 for tree maintenance. That's for Jim Edwards to come out to take out, remove our trees, stump grind them, whatever needs to take place. Treatment, I'm not sure if that's the correct number, but Zach would need to go around and kind of give us an idea of what he thinks we need, but 13,000 is probably a fairly safe number. We had 13,000 budgeted for this year. We spent six. We've got spring cleanup to still worry about. Last year, we ended up with 12,315. So we're probably pretty close on the money. It's better to remove the unsafe and diseased trees than have something happen.
So, and ash tree, remind me, Zach, did we treat the ash trees last year? We treated some of them, right?
We did have some. I think we had some sort of treatment done this year.
Yes, we half of them 1 year and half of them the next year. So they're on a 2 year treatment plan.
So we should have enough money in this year to cover treating half the ash trees.
The trees that were treated this year were treated in July. So the next treatment will be late June, early July.
Okay. So yeah, we do need to take care of that. Okay.
Yep. So that's going to be an ongoing thing for the life of these trees.
Correct. Okay. All right. The other numbers, I need to double check what the state retirement number is. I do have an estimated bill. I didn't get a chance to pull that to check it. The other ones are like workers' comp. I'm anticipating a quote or an idea how much things are going to change. And that's kind of where I'm at with the employee benefit portion.
Can you stop on workers' comp for a minute? So right now we've paid through the end of the calendar year 51 on a budget of 45.
On a budget of 51,000, okay. It's the number below.
Okay. So then the question is, is there another workers' comp payment due before the end of fiscal 2021?
There may be. I don't know that 100%.
No, I do. Is not. We are paid for the fiscal year. Workers' comp bill comes out in September. And for some reason, the salary numbers, they're wrong. I'm going to talk to the agent and see about getting them adjusted to get us an accurate number. It's not reflecting all the work we've been doing with the increased staff and DPW.
Okay, thanks.
And pandemic issues and stuff, right? Okay, so the 56 is just a guesstimate number in case their rates do go up, which chances are good that they will. All right, any other questions regarding that section? Moving on to debt service, bond principal, bond interest. I provided you the information in the packet. That's a non-negotiable item. Leased equipment, Ravo sweeper and the 219 Ford 450, non-negotiable items. Those are lease payments, and we've got nothing going on with that. Moving on to page 10 of the budget, expenditures. The only thing I threw in there is the $5,000 under the reserve account. We really, really need to keep putting money aside. So when we have some sort of calamity, we can not have to worry about pulling the money off a regular budget, but being able to access the money in this fund. So this is wishful thinking on my part. So the $5,000 is in as a placeholder. The other accounts I had mentioned last year are monies that we should really, on a normal every year basis, put some sort of money against these things to help defray some of the costs that some of these things do run us. So if we had, for instance, under DPW building improvements, if we had a fund and we were funding it, we could have, in the 20 years that I've been here, we could have probably bought a new building or something pretty close. That kind of thing where it wouldn't impact the annual budget, but we would be taking it off another revenue source. That said,
Mary, question for you. Where is the current roll-up of the .1 accounts?
I don't have a current roll-up of the .1. What are you talking about? Are you talking about DPW? DPW is the only one that I do a roll-up of, and that's 5110.1.
Okay, so my question is, in each of the departments, we have a .1 account, and that has the personnel salary, and those are all budgeted at zero. We talked about this earlier. So the
Just the DPW is.
That's the DPW. Okay, so where is the roll-up of the DPW? What page is that on?
5110.1, and that is on
5110.1. Okay, so
yes,
we
it's
have
on page 5 of the expenditures. It's 244,000.
Yeah. So we have a roll-up of 244. Do we know, is that higher, lower, or the same than was budgeted? It's tough to tell because, you know, you got to add up all these documents.
I can't honestly tell you correctly at this point because this is a modified number that I started to work on. So it's not a correct number. I will be fixing this along with all the other wage numbers. I did not have the opportunity to do that today.
Okay.
I got all this other stuff together. So I will have that more in place the next time we gather.
So that's a pretty big part of any budget is the personnel amounts.
Yes, so it is. But what I did, Dan, is I plugged in basically last year's numbers times 2.5% to kind of give me a roundabout number. But different from last year, we've had a change in personnel and a shifting of personnel. So I have to go in and modify what those numbers reflect for the current staff versus what we had last time around.
Okay. Thanks.
All right. So, sure. So moving on the revenues, I have made no modifications whatsoever. I just basically kind of popped in what we had. I may have made one modification. Where did I make it? Oh, I added 102 for rental property. So revenues I'm waiting to the very end to do so that I have a better handle on what the comptroller is looking for, what Monroe County is seeing that we're getting for Monroe County sales tax. We should, on that one, we should be getting another sales check mid-February. So that'll give me a little bit of an indicator of how close we're coming to our budgeted number and whether or not we may or may not exceed the number that we had reduced last year. So
Mary, like my question is on the existing, what you know already. Did the 269,833 come in above or below what we had estimated through the end of the calendar year?
Basically about the same. I mean, it was a difference of maybe a couple of $100 one way or the other. I have provided for you in prior meetings a copy of what the sales tax figure is so you can compare it by quarters. So you have that information, and I will send out a new one as soon as I get the new sales check in, so we'll have a better handle on where we stand with that number. But that's kind of where it's at for right now.
Okay, thanks.
So I'm hoping that we come out a little bit higher than what we have actually budgeted, because the initial reports, if you may recall from last budget season, was that we would be dropping 20 to 30% lower than the number that we had initially in place. So we went through and we modified that number down so that our revenues would be more in line with, without really hurting us on the expense side. So we'll see where we come out. I'm hoping that we come out somewhere close to that.
That's how we
all
got
right,
from
so,
2 to the 456.
Correct.
Yeah.
So that said, I haven't done any work on the modifications for the revenue. I'm going to hold off on that kind of to the end until I have some better feel from the other agencies involved, and then we could take it from there. My biggest thing was trying to get a handle on what expenses we have and what we need to go forward with. So after looking at the budget, as I have it right now, knowing that I still have to make some mild modifications, actually I need to take out 25,000 here and I think add 2,500. We are at a difference of 293,191. That number needs to be zero at the end of the day at a tentative budget. So there's a lot of work to be done here. We're waiting for a lot of quotes to come back, and we'll see where we sift out in the next couple of weeks, and hopefully we'll have some stronger answers. That said, any questions or any changes that the board would like to make to any of the numbers that I have at this time?
No, thank you, Mary.
All right. Okay. I'm good then. Go ahead,
Mary. 708. Mary, I'm going to let you finish up.
No, I'm saying I'm done.
Okay. I'll make a motion to adjourn. Do I have a second? No,
hold on. I'm not done. So, just so everybody knows, the number of the current budget over last year's is an increase of 10.2%. With the way it is now, obviously it's going to change. That's too high. So I'm hoping that we can, so we're going to have to do one of two things or a combination of a couple of things. Obviously, Mary's going to keep working and keep refining the numbers, and they may float up or down some, but we're going to have to either reduce our wish list items or raise taxes significantly or both. So that's where we are.
Right. But
right now we're at a 10% increase to the trustees. Just everybody know that.
Right. Okay. And I need to modify some expense numbers and stuff, and I haven't done anything with the revenues. So those will fluctuate out also, and it might come down to a different number altogether. But anyway, thank you very much to everyone.
Okay. I'll make a motion to adjourn. Do I have a second?
So wait, before we do that, what are next steps before the next meeting? What do we need to be working on before the next budget meeting?
If you have a particular project that you are looking at, I would need to get quoted numbers or some sort of move forward decisions.
We're going to try to have refined numbers. And I think the focus of next the next budget meeting is going to set priorities and probably start to cut or reduce some of the expenses in the budget.
Yeah. Okay.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We'll just.
I'm hopeful.
So the plan is to just do that a couple of times, just kind of do the same exercise again with more accurate numbers. I actually don't have that wasn't accurate. So what I just told you was just a change in the revenues. We're in, was it 10%? So where is your roll up, Mary, of the entire budget? I think that's on page.
You go to each page of the revenue, last page of the revenues, last page of the expenses. Hold on a second.
Yeah, so let me look at the last
total
expenses.
Yes, on page 13 of the revenues, we have a total.
I got that. I got an increase in the expenses. So that's on page what?
Hold on. It's 10. Probably page 11 or something like 10, 11. It's at the bottom of page 10. So that's 10. At 1763708.
Okay.
Right now, which is due for modification. So that's not a take to your heart kind of thing.
Okay, got it. Oh, so you just have, an idea you have the revenue have. Match. You have the revenues matching the appropriations. Okay.
Right. They need to. Right now, if you look at the revenues, what the revenues are at the moment, it's really 1,470,517, which says that we would have to dip into appropriated fund balance of $293,000.
Yeah.
We do not have that. We cannot go there with that kind of money. So there will need to be some sort of modification one way or the other. So I can raise the revenue some and I could decrease the expenses some to kind of come to that zero. But that's an exercise that the board has to do over the next few weeks to really figure out what is considered priority, what is considered feasible to get done within this fiscal year, and then we roll with it with a tentative budget that has equal that the revenues and the expenditures equal one another for a tentative budget, so the number has to be the same on both sides.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, all right. So we have a motion on the floor to adjourn. Is there a second?
Second. Lanfear.
Would you call a vote, please?
I will. Trustee Keating.
Keating, aye.
Trustee Stetser.
Stetser, aye.
Trustee Lanfear.
Lanfear, aye.
Mayor Corby.
Corby, aye. Thank you, everybody. Have a good evening.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you.
Bye.